Iconic. Iconic. That's funny.
Mabo and Jimmy. Mabo's so happy. Cuteness is justice. That's why he's loved by Jimmy. Mabo and Jimmy. Jimmy's so silly. Cuteness is justice. That's why Mabo loves Jimmy.
Hello, this is Mabo.
And Jimmy.
And Francesco.
Welcome back, guys.
We're very excited, that's all.
Yes. We are about to watch RuPaul's Drag Race Season 13, Episode 14, Reunited. So,
yes.
So they are back, you know, all after a couple months, they probably watch the show and they talk about it.
How much break is it in between the reunion?
Probably they filmed in the summertime, so like August.
That's when they filmed it?
Yeah.
So when would the reunion?
It's now, almost. So probably March.
Oh, since then. Several months.
They know what episode looked like,
gotcha.
So they must
perfect.
Watch.
Right? You're right.
That's what I'm guessing. Yeah. I'm wearing a plastic t-shirt, by the way. And Jimmy is...
And I'm wearing... Dina Martina, he'll put it down in the thing. You have to watch her drag. Yeah. Her drag is hysterical. Yeah. She's from Seattle, but she's just bananas.
Yeah, yeah. That's kind of our
just
our
bananas.
Comedy.
and our comedy, we like wonderful. Check it out.
Check it out.
Okay,
let's see. Bring back my girl tonight. We celebrate the sisters of season 13. Brought back everybody.
Sit down and shut the hell up. Is it gonna be Zoom?
It looks like two Zoom, yeah. We've got Nick, Candy Mutes,
Rose, and Simone. They changed.
As they arrive to rehearse for next week's grand finale.
Yeah!
Well, they've had months to prepare.
Yeah!
Now, the finale will be an entirely different show.
Next week. It'll
be interesting if there's a crowd or not. I don't think they will.
Yeah,
they'll do it like
right?
Before where they're sitting in front of a. An empty audience.
I don't think he's ready for that.
To the theater at the Ace Hotel in downtown Los Angeles.
Maybe.
When we're preparing
it's
for next week's grand finale. First, we're celebrating each of the eliminated queens from their hometowns. And we'll be premiering music videos they've each created exclusively for this reunion. Now, we may not be back to normal, but we are definitely back to sickening. Hashtag Drag Race.
Yay!
Sickening. Bring back my girl. Wow, look how gorgeous you are. From Chicago, she's a living Mackie doll. Kamara Hall.
From the House of
Gold.
That's good.
Gold.
Now I understand where that video is from. Because I've seen that video.
Wow.
She's Atlanta royalty, Tamisha Iman.
Hello, Mama.
Hello, Mama.
Don't break me, it's Lala Ree.
Oh, lovely.
That looks good.
I love this
strip. It's Elliot with two T's.
Hey, y'all.
Hi.
What's good?
Where are you?
She's in an ice.
She's
in an ice drink.
Lovely.
She almost looks like ice.
Miss Tina Burner. What's up,
bitches? I wish you brought this.
Yeah, I know.
Oh my god.
Thank God. Oh wow.
Wow, look at all that.
Whoever said New Yorkers guys aren't polite never met Olivia Lux.
Hey girl.
Olivia looks different.
My queen.
I like that big old wave.
Now you all made drag history in the most lip-syncing season ever. Oh what?
Girl, what?
I don't think you want to think of the black
picture. It seems like so long ago, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's just as hard to swallow as Lonnie Love's comedy career.
You're the one bombing!
Oh,
yay!
Yes. Just
I'm getting to the bathroom, like, can we just?
Category is fashion. This has never been done on the runway. You look rich.
There's a lot of good runway costumes.
Oh my god, men.
Yeah.
She is the wind beneath her own
damn
wings.
This
was like my wet dream.
That's so
fashion,
60s.
But it's edgy and you.
That is right?
One of the greatest outfits Puckets. I had on
60s,
the day.
Oh no, oh that. That was from the like the 30s, 40s, 50s. People selling watches. Wow.
Disco.
He sounds like the voice of Broadway.
He wants to do that.
Candy, wait. I'm not ready for you to go. You really have no
well,
idea.
She made it to finals, so that was a good save, I guess.
And when you learn about it.
You are a star. I'm proud of each and every one of you.
Wow.
Too many.
First, let's check in with a queen who likes to take her own sweet time.
Kamora?
Yeah.
She was late.
Kamora
was
sweet. For the rich white woman fantasy.
For the runway.
Who's ready for a bite of this?
Also, Paul.
Oh, yeah, that's...
Sorry, Rue, I was just finishing up my makeup. Y'all eliminated me way too early. No. Like I said, I promised y'all, but Maggie Doll is not going back in the box. From the first episode where I walked out in my original Maggie dress and Carson Presley's jaw to Rob's. It's an original Bob Mackie.
What?
It's my phenomenal performance and my inspired Maggie dance costume. The sheer runway inspired by Cher's Met Gala dress.
Oh, wow.
If I have to describe my judges' journey in one word, it would have to be anxiety.
Anxiety.
Y'all saw how much it was a struggle bus for me to get ready. I have gotten faster. I don't take 4 hours anymore. I take 3. Okay? Baby steps. I'm 25% faster now.
Why did you leave me all these years ago?
My fully padded green suit moment.
Yes.
Sexy palm tree, willow tree, or something. Instead, I was just like this big trunk with just my face. So I looked crazy.
I was rooting for us. I was rooting for us!
Rooting.
My team was
no,
shady.
But she struggled.
They all
so much.
I was doing the race, and they all hopped behind my bag at the confessionals.
I'm watching a train wreck happen right in front of me.
But I can do it now. I was rooting for... Wait, no. I was rooting for us. The fan reaction has been great. I got a message from someone saying, you know, thank you for representing the Asian queer community on RuPaul's Drag Race. You know, representation really does matter, and the fact that I was able to walk down the runway in a very Asian drag-inspired dress showed that I am proud of my culture and where I come from. And seeing those messages from, you know, the Asian American community means a lot to me. I hope y'all are ready for this next performance. It's sexy, it's sultry, it's a tribute to my drag mother. I'm about to give you everything you all feel.
Yes.
I love it. Now, in a music video she produced all by herself.
We're gonna do this for each one of them.
That's right, cool. So.
How much time do we have?
Wow. So each queen gets a music video like this?
Ah, that's pretty
cool. Wow.
This is gonna be a long show.
Hey, babe.
Where are you?
Where are you?
It's so Kamora. I like this.
Wow.
I wonder who chose the song? Myself?
Mm-hmm. Who must have had their own choice? It's their own production.
Oh wow, look at that. Did you see that?
Yeah,
that's mm-hmm. Wonderful, lovely.
Hi, babe. I've been waiting for you.
Oh my god. Wow. She could be a problem.
Of course.
Gorgeous.
Yeah.
Our finalist is arriving. Let's go to our queen cam.
Big deal. Congrats on making it to the top four.
Thank you.
Got time for 69 questions?
I mean, I guess.
Describe your drag race experience in 3 words.
I'd have to say gorge. Gorge.
Michelle.
Michelle Visage impression.
I love this.
A piece of fabric.
Name a superpower you wish you had.
I've always wanted to be able to teleport because I am the most impatient person in the entire world. LA traffic does not help.
NWO toys.
If you could beat anyone's mug, whose would it be?
Raven, if you ever have a sick
That
day,
was Raven, yep.
That's me.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Daphne, looking back at how I won Drag Race 5 years ago.
And finally, what's your favorite thing about being a drag queen?
Definitely the fact that I get to crash the system with my art. Oh, and the rhinestone.
And the rhinestone?
Yeah. Yeah.
Very good. That was great.
I thought the interviewer's voices, Alexis, Michelle, or Raven, either one of them.
Oh, I know, I don't remember.
I thought.
I so totally didn't pay attention.
I was just listening to Gutmeek.
This next queen left her fans thirsty for more, just as Candy Muse. Take a look.
I'm a gay actress, I'm Joey J. This is wacky, this is crazy. I'm gay as. I'm gonna. Rainbows and glitter, and it's gonna be everything. Hi, cutie. The gay agenda is here. The dance mega mix house done with the back bare back. Coming in, I wasn't a very well-known queen, and I'm like, I'm gonna make fun of myself before anybody else can. So the queen, bitch, maybe I am. If I go home, I wasn't lying. And if I whooped everyone's ass, y'all just got beat by a filler queen. Gotcha. It's kind of like a win-win. This season,
that's
like,
funny. I always wondered about that.
We walked in and there were twists right out the gate.
Welcome, ladies.
Candy looks at me and she's like, bitch, are we about to lip sync? And I'm like, and there's so much anticipation. And then bam, you're going home.
Sashay away.
Come on, chicken feathers.
I was surprised. I didn't think a chicken feather was going to like make or break someone's entire career, Denali.
I'm just not a fan of chicken feathers. Sorry, girl.
$200, then like you're probably still paying yours off. So
clap, clap.
I'm feeling great.
Wow.
Wig, I thought, I love that. I knew the no wig queen was going to be like controversial, and I was ready for the wrath of Michelle Visage. But the fan base absolutely love it. It's so validating to hear from so many people. Like, I'm so happy you stuck to your brand, and I'm getting so many pictures of people embracing the no wig thing. I absolutely love it. My runway journey is a little bit different. I don't think the judges quite understood my draft.
I just thought that was poison.
IV. I was playing for IV bag. And he's like, well, why isn't it poison IV bag? But I'm like, we have to do like a type of bag. And I'm like, well, poison IV bag is in a bag. An IV bag is a bag. But like a poison IV bag is
but
a
it's
one.
Supposed to be.
It was an IV bag.
She's still not getting the
IV
joke.
On the costume. Does that make sense? How about we just like move forward and just like don't look at it?
That's funny.
I wasn't going in to find a relationship, and then next thing you know, Candy is chasing me. You've seen Godzilla, right? It's like that. But like watching that episode with Candy, it made me like butterflies. Like I got a little verklempt. So I was like, oh my god. Like, and being embraced for like just being who I am. Like, we don't need this mask anymore. So the fans are asking if anything is happening between me and Candy. Maybe it already has, baby. Don't worry about it. Baby, I might have been eliminated second, but you haven't even seen anything yet. This video is going to be so cute, throwback nostalgia.
Oh.
It's going to be the only gay ass bitch in it.
Okay, up next, here she is in her own gay ass music video.
Fuck yeah, shit. Let's say this motherfucker. Yes, that's what I thought it was gonna be like.
Oh, she's singing.
Oh, that's all him. That's hysterical. I love this.
That's so fucking cute.
It's like in sync of Backstreet Boy.
Wow.
That's her in each one, right?
Yeah.
Kind of fun.
I love the one in the middle.
That's supposed to be Timberlake in the middle. That's supposed to be Justin Timberlake. But that's her? Oh my god.
She's seeing herself right now because she's at a bar in Phoenix. She said she was gonna be there. So that's crazy that she's seeing this.
Like, this, this is really good.
I love this.
She really did a great job. The guy on the left. I don't even know his name, but that's exactly what he looks like.
AJM?
I don't know. The only one I know is just. Oh, and him. And he's the gay one.
It's a word, Silver Queen.
The only out one.
Oh my god.
Very good. Wow, that was good.
That was
good. That was real.
No!
This is good.
You anywhere. Can I ask you 69 questions?
Sure.
In season 13 were a Broadway musical, what would it be called?
The Never Ending Story.
Who would be the villain?
Who would be the villain?
Who would be the love interest?
Didn't not see you there. Come in.
Denali?
Who would be your understudy?
Jennifer Aniston.
Name a historical era you'd like to live in.
The 80s.
Why?
So I can hang out with Tina Burner.
If you'd like to become a rosé woman. What's a phrase drag queens use way too much?
I did not come here to make friends.
Now say that again with a Scottish brogue.
I didn't come here for mates.
Wow. Did come here for mates?
On the show.
Oh my god. When you got it, you got it.
And lastly, what's your favorite thing about being a drag queen?
Changing people's minds.
Hallelujah.
Break the leg.
I should have fell. That would have been funny. That's how I would have ended it. Break a leg. What?
Yay!
Very good.
Yeah, I like the Joey music video. That was amazing.
And I love the whole 69 questions thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was good.
They put Joey J and Rosé after each other. Mwah! So that I could get excited,
then. That's right. That's your favorite.
Yeah, my two tops.
So you can smooth.
Yeah.
You can all climb for a while.
Yes. I can just
take a nap.
Welcome back to RuPaul's Drag Race Reunited. Tamisha and Mon, take a look.
Come on.
Tamisha is here. I am Tamisha Iman, one of the baddest in the art form of female impersonation. She's one of those classy, sassy ladies, but at the same time, I can be that B-I-T-C-H if need be.
Category
club. Hi, guys. Initially, I was cast on season 12, but 1 year later, I fought back, and I knew if I didn't strike now, I was never going to get back there. So let's come back that I didn't even think I had.
The Legends Ball.
The sheer runway look is Bam. Always going to be one of my favorites. So when Ru said,
it is one of the most beautiful dresses that has ever graced this stage.
To blew my mind. It's one thing to mark RuPaul doing Cher in your home and be like, whoa! But who would have ever thought in a million years I would actually get that part of what Ru is known for doing? All thing I didn't say was, snap out of it! It was so fun. I enjoyed that the most. Bring it to the runway. Being Lala on the show was amazing because I felt so proud that I had just a slight hand to play in that start of this great entertainer the world gets to see.
Best of your show.
She put me in drag many, many years ago, honey. I think the way the show started with the pork chop group, Lala built a lot of bonds with the people that were in her wedding circle. It's no shade or anything like that. I am just a real type of person.
It's a couple of girls in here I don't care for.
You won. When Ken and I got into it in Untucked, it was true emotions coming out.
I say what I say.
To gain the power that I never had in my community. But you're not going to mesh with everybody. So Ken and I would never be friends.
but I don't wish her any
ill. Her makeup almost looks cartoon, like you're looking at an old 50s, like, cartoon drawing. The way the shadows and everything, the non-blending.
But if the cameras was not there, I would have hit her.
Out of him.
When I was eliminated, it was two different emotions. This is not right, and crew is finally over.
No tea.
I learned, regardless of what the cards were dealt to me, I've always played my hand.
Kind of feel that when you go home, it's the right time for you to go home. There's no more growth. Because what we're going to throw at you is you're going to suck, I think.
Well, unless they feel like they haven't gotten a show with their true talent yet.
Right.
So that's why they are like, fuck it, I deserve to be here. Yeah.
Right.
But I know what you're saying, of course.
Now, in a music video to her original track,
if they're really something, but sometimes it's club comp.
So arrogant.
Yes, this is it.
Oh my god. Bam.
Oh, that's cool. I like her mirror dress, or in their vests. Those are like mirror panels almost. Way to feature her, the girls, and get them more audience.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Followers.
Bring back Kamara Hall, Joey J, and Tamisha Amon.
Oh.
Hi, Tamisha. Hi, Joey.
Hi, cutie. Tamisha, you look stunning in purple. Kamara, I love your belly button.
All right, Tamisha, I've got some fan questions for you.
Okay.
So Jaden from Reno wants to know, have your kids seen the show? And what are their thoughts about it?
We still, at this very moment, haven't had a conversation about it. So, my kids are grown. They're actually older than you, Kamara. So, when they're ready, they know where I'm at. All right, Kamara, the Myth Mappy doll. If you were a tree, what kind of tree would you be?
Trigger. But if I were a tree, I'd probably be a coconut tree because we both got big nuts.
I think you're really trying to branch out with that. But we're rooting for you.
Yay!
We have a question from Michelle from South Plainfield. She writes, big hair. Are we ever going to see it?
Oh. Tonight. Well, this is awkward.
Joey, that is your Anita Baker cat. That is not the care.
You know what? Mind your business, Lisa.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I'm kind of disappointed with this look. I wanted to see a more... He did it in the video.
Which one?
Joey.
Without the wig look?
No, or this look. I just wanted to see more of a suit.
Yeah, maybe she's going to bring up more in the finale.
This will be good.
Hey, you're Candy Muse. What is that?
So nice to see you. Mind if I ask you 69 questions?
You're naughty. But 69 is my favorite number.
Describe yourself in a hashtag.
Hashtag star quality, baby.
If you were actual candy, what would you be?
I think I'd be sour candy because you either like me or you don't.
What's a moment from this season you wish you could do over?
Pockets. Delete the entire episode.
Name one thing you'd like to mop from RuPaul's closet.
RuPaul's wigs.
What's one thing you actually mopped from your season 13 sisters?
Got mixed wigs.
What's one thing people don't know about you yet?
If I told you, then you'd know.
Who do you look up to the most?
Myself, because I'm an icon.
Repeat after me. Sally sells seashells by the seashore.
Go f*** yourself.
Any plans to do stand-up comedy?
Yeah, actually, I want to go on tour with Utica and Simone.
You might win.
And finally, about being a drag queen.
Good.
The attention, darling. Also, big enough to learn when I want to be left alone. As in, right now. Bye.
Thanks, Candy. Break a lash.
Break a leg.
Sound off with hashtag.
Oh, you're supposed to give like.
Right, never give said lash.
Oh, he did say lash?
That's right. Wow.
I can see the dance.
Wow. I'm wowing to Elliot with double T.
Oh, so we can finally see him dance.
Yeah.
He's supposed to be like a fabulous
girl
dancer, and we.
From Dallas. Like, we didn't.
We got to see some of it, but it'd be great if he could showcase it. Because now they've had months to put this together. So I'm guessing WOW Presents helped each one of them film the 16 questions.
This is
they probably sent him a kid.
And their video.
This is amazing.
Do you think Gottmik got her own video?
I don't know.
I think they either did 69 questions or a video.
Yeah.
Maybe they did it both. That's just going to be a long show if they're going to show all of their videos.
Okay, well. I don't think they have on tap, so they might have
TV. Ooh, I see now. Damn.
Drag Race is a life-changing experience, especially if it's the La La Ree experience. Oh, take a look. Oh, what you say? What you say? La La Ree is here to play. La La Ree is like a Olive Garden pasta with like Popeye's chicken tenders on the top for the red with So I was still describing myself as the Olive Garden pasta salad with the chicken tenders sprinkled on top. Oh my ass, I can love balsamic vinaigrette. That's the Gucci Hall eat. Balsamic vinaigrette, girl. And whoa. Like, did I say it right? Balsamic vinaigrette? I'm asking for a long time. But I could describe my drag race journey in one word, it would be short.
That's funny. Wow, La Ree was here.
Fuck.
Because, you know, pre-drag race, I was a leotard girl child, but, you know, I didn't want to share to read me, so I tried to step outside my comfort zone. I am proud of myself.
Oh.
The main look, the doll situation, which I found out was not lame, it was LeMay. But, you know, I am actually a little mom. I hear she's in the new Bond film, Gold Sphincter. My personal favorite of my looks was my snake look, honey, when I was literally down in the world. I was the proud of that look. We have to use our voices and do the right thing. The hardest thing for me to watch from the show was definitely the Black Lives Matter conversation, talking about Rayshard Brooks and George Floyd. It's very hard for me to watch to this day. You know, I still kind of get choked up. But definitely having a conversation like that definitely brought me and myself closer, because we all realize that sometimes we actually go through the same exact thing. Use that platform wisely. And get in some good trouble. Felicia Iman was like the first person to put me in drag, so that was definitely like a full circle moment. See, I can't still let them in, baby. I see her the local cobble, girl. I got her local bread, girl. What's a meal, girl? That's all I can afford right now, because I didn't get that $100,000 check.
So, bitch, oh my gosh. I hope that La La Ree does something with Candy Muse, because their show would be wild. You need to go on ecstasy and all kinds of drugs.
It's hard to understand.
Yeah.
I am understanding 1/5 of what he's saying. I am not understanding what he's talking about. I mean, I get it, but I'm just. It's so hard to understand.
Accent.
My God, girl.
Like, that's what makes people love them.
Exactly, I love it. But I just want to rewatch it later.
I'm actually starting to understand.
I got used to Candy.
Candy, it's getting used to. Lala wasn't on the show long enough, and she's so excited right now. Yeah. It's hard to catch every other word, but anyway.
What's up?
I'm ready. I'm familiar with it.
Actually, a lot of original money, it's ratchet, it's a good time, baby. And guess what? No paper bags for harm to make her disappear. Here with her own original
song. I like the hug. look today.
Here's Lala Reese.
That bitch. I love the wig.
Should know
that it is not as easy as it looks.
Exactly.
If you were doing drag, what would you be doing?
Ew. Nothing.
Yeah.
What's your favorite thing about being a drag queen?
That I get to express myself.
Oh. Congrats on an amazing season. Break a lash, Simone.
Oh, thank y'all. I'll see y'all after.
Well, at least all the 69 questions, I love them all. We got them all. Amazing.
That was really quickly. Yeah.
Probably told them a thing just before they shot it.
Oh.
Then boom, they had to get it. Stop at that wall and turn. They all stopped at the restroom sign going down the stairs. They all stopped. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
What is your favorite animal? Platypus. Something like that.
Oh my God.
What's your favorite tree?
Show a picture of
platypus. My favorite tree?
Platypus.
Sakura.
Two T's.
Sakura. Oh my God. I love that.
Okay. I know where my strengths are. Dancing, acting, singing. And girl, I'm so ready.
Yeah.
I wish you had acted more.
Yeah.
My journey on season 13 was bumpy.
Yeah. Hey, buddy.
I have been the only queen in Drag Race history to have been eliminated 3 times in a single season. I'm sorry, my dear. You're getting the pork chops. I don't like pork chops. Difficult to watch back because you almost want to feel sorry for that person, but then you're like, oh, it's me. But now I'm not afraid of anything. As Britney Spears would say, I'm stronger than yesterday. And she is.
Cheerleader mode.
The positive things that came out of being on Drag Race was allowing the world to be able to see my passion for performing and dance. When it comes to fish, I'm the biggest fan. That is my art, that is my life, that is my soul. And so the reactions that I've gotten from
people, that dance was impeccable.
Magical. Yeah. One of the most shocking moments for me that I had no idea about was Kimora finding my voice to be annoying.
This is something really annoying.
Rude. Messy girl. She's my sister. I love her, but she's messy. I think a really impactful moment for me on the show was being able to talk about my struggles with depression. I think it's something that a lot of people really don't fully understand. It literally is something that I have no control over.
Yeah.
The few times that I've interacted with people where they told me that they have depression as well and they struggle with it, but hearing my story and seeing me on TV really helped lift them. And moments like that, it makes all the struggle and all the difficulty worth it. And that's all I could ever ask for. The song I'm going to be performing is kind of like a love letter to my dancers and my choreographer, Jack Bean. It's a message that you can come from nothing, and if you work really hard and you don't give
up... Actually, that was funny.
You can literally do whatever you want.
Yes, it was cartoony.
Yeah, you know, like a Japanese
type of...
Now,
in a music video she produced herself, Prince Miss Elliot...
Dad!
Let's see how Miss Elliot...
She looks sexy as fuck. Really, I think she's very sexy.
I don't. There's room for everybody.
Oh my god. Rude.
I love the makeup. That's what I'm referring to. It's a beautiful girl.
I know this song.
She could have a little more energy in it.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like she did it so many times and they just took. Her energy's not in this.
Mm-hmm. In my eyes, I guess.
There's a few times, like right there for 2 seconds. Yeah.
Good
children in dance class. Now, it's time to spill several teas with Elliot and Lala Reed.
Hey, Miss Lala, how are you, girl? Oh my god, you look so gorgeous.
I don't think you've heard this whole thing I put on the back of my closet, sister.
So listen, girl, I have some fan questions for you, okay?
Girl, bring it to me, girl.
Matisse from Baton Rouge, who says, you are cute and funny as hell, girl. So, what do you find more attractive in a man? Do you find good looks or good sense of humor? Talk about it.
Ooh, girl, y'all are getting personal, huh, child? So since I have such a huge personality, a good sense of humor goes a very long way with me, child. So you have to have a really nice sense of humor. But baby, ain't there wrong with a good look here, too? And a good bank account. So Miss Elliot with 2 feet, girl. Miss Sheila from DC wants to know who was the season 13 dancing queen. I mean, I already know the answer, but girl, you can go ahead and give it to me anyway.
I love you, Lala, girl, but I'm out here to twirl, okay? I'm the dancing queen of this season with a side of Lala.
I said dancing, so fast, because you danced Demi Hall.
Oh, yeah, that's fine.
I love you, Lala. I love you so much. I can't wait to see you in the dancer, girl. We're going to have fun.
Listen, girl, when you come out to that child, I'm going to bring you to the autumn spot. We're going to get up some limits for queens, girl. And then when I come to bank, you're taking a host role.
No!
Coming up, 2 queens
who are top and cool. That's cute now that I see it again, but on pause.
Until it moves.
Exactly.
Evil.
Evil.
That's what you were thinking.
But maybe they could
it's
have
nice on pause.
I know.
And then it moves.
Oh my gosh. We might see her next week.
I know.
Oops. Sorry, Tina. I love you so much.
Just prove it. The undeniable Denali.
Denali!
Let me break the ice.
I'm Denali, and I am icy, spicy, and a little bit dicey. I am competitive. When I start to get mad at myself is when I push myself even harder. I'm going to show what I am capable of.
Hey,
oh my God. If I could sum up my journey in one word, it would be roller coaster. Spins, plot twists, turns, and dips and dives, like everything in all in between.
What the f*** is up on here?
I'm really proud of that lip thing. Yes, my little boy nip came out, but I still thought I had worked it out even with cement blocks on my feet. My favorite moment of the season was Phenomenon, being able to put on a great performance.
For you, I'm too spicy.
Being the top of the front day, and to be able to lip sync for that win, that was such a moment too where we both were like, bam! Oh, we all have a double boom. Obviously, I got close to my sister from another Mr. Rosé.
Thank you, Ru.
It's that very epic Rose Nolly moment in Untucked when she holds my hands and sends me out to war right before 100% Pure Love.
I really need you here with me. You know what to do.
And then as we continued on the competition, a lot of my successes happened to be alongside Rosé. A lot of the heartache and the pain happened to be alongside Rosé. So you never know. Few shots of some Scottish whiskey, anything can happen.
I like her color palette.
Yes. Yeah.
She didn't powder her nose underneath her thing, so she's got a shiny nose that's moving underneath where she tried to put it. So you've got to make sure it's all matte and it doesn't reflect any light. Or you've got a moving dot, and sometimes her dot, did you notice, is slightly over to the left?
Yeah.
Because they're still shining.
The biggest surprise to me was how well people connected to...
It looks like straight, and then a dot in here.
I was like, that was a bad day, you were in the bottom, you had to send your money home. And then I got home,
very
and
technical.
I got to see that lip thing, and I was
just
like...
looking. We're right up in her nose. See how it's moving?
I was like, what are you doing, girl? Stop, she's already dead.
You can look dance.
But also complimented my ass.
And you have a fat ass.
Truly, to get a compliment from your absolute idol on how thickums you are.
I'm loving this.
Means the world.
They change butt.
She is very into the knees.
As a muscle.
And
you never got to see her butt.
I was a little frustrated that I was in the bottom, but being back home and seeing my only girl, I know that it wasn't that great.
Where was the blending?
So for the fans that came for Olivia saying that she should have gone home, at the end of the day, we were the weakest team.
Who should go home tonight?
My only regret is not saying Tina Burner's name. Girl, we all saw it. We all saw it.
I think, yeah.
Inspiration for this video.
We all saw it.
And a little spicy. I'm a huge K-pop fan. I lived in Korea for a year and a half, reporting all the way from the Kiss and Cry.
He looks Asian.
It is time for me to lip skate.
He can look
for my life.
And no, now, serving a RuPaul day on ice.
I don't know.
I don't see it.
I don't know anymore.
I see it. Oh, look, what? Wait.
She's got
how do you like that?
I love that.
Yeah.
Wonderful. He's gonna become the ice
skating queen.
Yeah, which is good. There's none.
Nobody has.
Yeah. Dragi's becoming harder and harder.
Yeah.
To be attractive now. Yes, good. I was getting bored. Diverse.
Whee!
Oh my God, I've never seen that.
Whee!
Centrifugal, isn't it?
Yeah.
Throw! That's the number. Oh, she changed dress. We like that.
Triple XL.
She better do another.
Quadruple.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah. Talent.
Yeah.
The time has come to sleep or boot.
If you like courage,
it takes courage.
If you don't,
it takes courage.
Here we go. First up, Utica's bad boy.
Oh, this one's all
I think. Is this even a question right now? I'm tuning right now. It's so good.
But what I want to wonder is, how we had the same hours and the same time to make the same thing and she came out with the masterpiece.
same amount of time.
Did you ever shoot?
I really love that look.
Next up, Kimora's train look.
Toot.
Of course it's a
toot, honey. Kimora's whole wardrobe is a toot plus a toot.
Yes.
Honestly, also a shoot. It's just incredible. I love her.
Y'all were lucky they sent me home first.
This was controversial.
This is a boot.
Remember the next one?
Boom. It was...
Can we move to the next one?
I'm giving you fashion, I'm giving you different makeup, I'm giving you versatility.
Horrible.
I love it. I got a shoe.
The beige.
That skin tone looking thing just looked that odd, especially in the crotch. That's
a boot. Don't put that
in. She gonna get me for the
ass. All of them. The fuck?
Look over there.
Simone's train. Yes! Shoot,
shoot, shoot, shoot.
That's
a shoot. That's a shoot.
Cool.
That's just cool as shit.
And, oh, I didn't see that.
Yeah, she jumped over her train.
Every day, Simone, to the house down.
Yes.
No boots.
She's got the best youth cat.
Oh,
together.
Someday, your children will know.
Latina
like red, yellow, and orange.
Basically, that's what I was saying. They don't like
color palette unless done very well. Oh, dear. Oliver thinks I'm saying something terrible.
Sorry.
Listen, you hated it or you loved it.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
The only lyric.
That's that.
Then orange, yellow.
Maybe I like this look.
Who wore it best? We all brought the same drag.
I would be if there was a pandemic going on while we were doing all the same design. No,
it's tough when there are two looks and they're the same concept.
Oh, yeah.
Because there's always going to be someone that like outdoes the other.
Honestly, I would be a good old
got me one that one.
Queen box
Simone won that one.
So I wasn't stupid when I noticed similarity.
I'm Lala Ree's bad ball.
Oh, I'm gonna have to give this look a boot, and possibly a trash can.
It may be the worst look you have ever seen, but it will be more like that.
I'm gonna cute that.
True.
You know why? Because it was iconic.
She made that outfit a winning lipstick outfit. Let that sink in. Boom.
A winning lip sync outfit. That's funny.
She didn't go home.
No,
right, exactly. She didn't go home with that.
Right.
That's good.
It is my honor to present to you the first. So
go there, blow that one.
I need to see tea, so I'll
do it. Fine.
Francesco with two teeth.
Francesco with two teeth. Francesco. Fantesto. Fantesto. It's Fantesto. I know Fantesto with two T's. It's so dumb. It's funny.
I'm eating this.
Welcome back to RuPaul's Drag Race Reunited.
Welcome home,
Barbecue.
Our top four were
battling for the crown. But first,
the
sizzle in
season 13.
Tina Burnett, bitches. I'm Tina Burnett, and I'm here to premiere costume and comedy school. I have been a staple in the drag community for 10 years. I'm old. Nobody puts Burnett in the corner. Ooh, that ass.
That's her real ass.
I know.
Better makeup.
Drag Race 963 times. 525,600 minutes. So to actually walk through the door, it was very surreal. You didn't show it, but I actually walked through the door and hit my head. It was very embarrassing. I should know better. You tell what's yours. Favorite moment of the whole season was dressed as a Tin Man coming down the runway and RuPaul just going, Tina! I'm right here!
I've always wanted to play Mama Gears. The most fun in the disco challenge. That music kicked in and I was stretching down the runway and landing in the top. It was like amazing.
You were a disco queen to me tonight.
I think my lowest point in the competition was being in the bottom for the musical.
Yeah, that was
because coming from New York City and coming from theater is very important for me to do New York City proud. I stand by my choice to stop lip-syncing those 2 seconds in the musical because it was a comedy choice and I'm a comedy queen and mean. I have seen more memes about me than I can count. From Ronald McDonald to a sexy hot dog, baby, mission accomplished.
I didn't know Tina Burner owned flames and the color orange, red, and yellow.
I own flames and Tina Burner is the sexy.
Turn and burn it.
Rosé and I were paired together in the makeover. And I
wow, that is something.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Stumbling foot when you leave the house and you realize that you left the stove on. During the competition, I got really close with my Mean Girls trio. Candy and Mick and I became really, really tight, and fans were not that receptive. Here's the thing, y'all. Mean Girls, one of the campiest, funny movies I've ever seen, is about having fun, being stupid, and making fun of yourself. That's what Mean Girls is.
We love it, right? Yeah.
I'm going to do an original song with a lot of my local queens from New York City, and it's time to celebrate what I do. You think you love my lovely lady lumps? Well, no, I lost that lip sync, so get ready. This is going to be much better.
Yay!
I like him a lot more now. Yeah. I really do like him now. He kind of like people after.
Turn it and burn it.
I was worried I was never going to get that.
Turn it and burn it.
Didn't your parents ever teach you not to play with fire?
Oh, wow. Those are the other queens. Yes.
Mabo. Yeah. Those must be her friends. Sorry, Zach.
Like real women?
Yeah, those are probably other New York queens.
Exactly, that's for them.
Yeah.
I can't like the concert.
And now it's time for a recap.
Okay. Wow, cool.
And out of season 13, Tina Burner and Denali.
Denali, my beautiful angel, you look gorgeous. How are you doing?
Thank you, Dad.
Dad.
The hell out of you. I believe you're serving me some Alaska Night Sky.
Aurora Borealis, you know. All right, Miss Tina Burner, now I have fan mail questions for you. Bruce from Billings wants to know, you and Rosé were really funny in the Doppelganger Challenge. What was that like, and are y'all close, or are y'all frenemies?
I'm gonna give you the real tea. I still hate her! Oh, no, I'm just kidding. We're closer than we were before. I'll tell you that much, and there was none before. So guess what? We're an inch closer.
So y'all got an inch closer, and we got 8 inches closer.
No, I'm just kidding. Denali, cold, I'll say, because it is from Elsa from Saskatoon. Are you going to be playing any ice-themed drag shows like Twinks on Rinks? Or, trade on blades?
That's possible.
That's funny. The second the world opens up, you better believe I'm gonna have my own nice show starring me. So, yeah.
I'm thinking maybe we should collaborate. Little heat miser, snow miser.
Yeah, you can do the number from Blades of Glory, whether fire and ice.
I mean, considering my, skating ability.
You'd be the stem, I'd be the flower.
Yeah, that kind of works for me.
All right, Dad, another fan mail question for you. Trina from Tallahassee asks, what's the weirdest thing we didn't see you do in a workroom?
Win a challenge.
Good for you.
But
he can not let
it. I wish she could stay one more week for the Rose Challenge.
Now, could have been bad or good.
Yeah, it could be good.
To the reunion of our top four queens.
Oh, now we're going.
Red hair.
Someone got here with some orange hair.
I did. I said, let me go do something a little different. But now we got it.
Yeah. Alrighty. Then we almost thought you got eliminated. We was like, where is the mom?
Oh, you thought over you?
We were sitting here. Where you been?
Maybe I'll be ready for the finale. Are y'all ready?
Isn't it wild?
It's insane.
Bitch, this would be such an iconic finale.
The looks. The looks.
My looks are actually game over. Like, I'm ready to pill it.
Oh.
Restart the engine.
Siesta. Jose is gonna go and slay New York.
Nah.
Welcome, ladies. Now this is where all the magic happens.
See?
Y'all nervous?
No,
a little bit. Look at my children have all grown up.
Definitely gonna up my Botox level for sure.
Full of filler at this point.
No, I'm
full of hate now.
Well, there's that too.
I
like,
missed you.
Well, are y'all ready?
I'm sorry.
Absolutely. Yeah. Let's get about this.
Yeah. Now, have you all remained friends?
Oh, yeah. Very close.
And I feel like we're the closest, like.
Too close.
Oh, baby.
So, who's
going to
win next week?
Me.
Definitely. Like, no question. Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you, I'll be the judge of that.
Yes, you will.
Well, yeah.
Your name is on the marquee.
But seriously, I just want to tell you all, just savor the moment. Because you look back on this and you think, it all went by so fast. So just savor it. Swish it around in your mouth a little bit. You know how to swish, don't you?
Oh, absolutely.
I'm not the one with swish, baby.
Now, will you do me the honor of introducing our next guest?
He's just a man. He's probably a pig.
Utica!
Stick the name. I am Utica Queen, and I am the wacky and flavorful of the arms too. I'm all about the goof, the woof,
bitch is crazy.
Just it's me, Utica Queen, summing up Drag Race in one word has been kooky. Included in the show was when I first entered the main stage and I talked to Rue. I talked about the experience, how I was struck by lightning. And shocking, I know.
You've been struck by lightning?
Yeah, I flew off the ground. I think it was like 10 feet up in the air. And I think that explains why I'm so full of energy.
It was a testament to how I can just like keep on going. Yeah. It's electric. I really loved all the things that I wore. Look, I love that one. The earrings with the little earrings.
I love it.
The curtains look. I'm going to have to say my favorite challenge is the design challenge. I feel like I was definitely in my element. Walking down the runway, I felt as powerful as I could ever imagine. Even if I know that I'm not going to be good at something, I at least go for it. I think the praying squirrels in my head would be proud. Maybe like a soft applause.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you could speak whale.
I don't understand the difference between humor and insult.
You want to try not to be mean, but cut and funny.
I've grown and seen the way that jokes can be told and how they can definitely come from a place of love. I definitely want to strive for that instead of just like relying on this just bad sense of humor. For the makeover challenge, when I definitely feel like embodied Simone changed me as an artist. I feel more confident in my work and just feeling so beautiful and so
I love that way.
And powerful. And thank you, Simone, for teaching me
this wig or this wig.
Kiss to that energy in my
soul. It's like that. It's a nice white wig.
So much joy in lip syncing. I feel like it's one of my favorite things about being a drag human. I definitely feel like I put my stamp on that stage and had a great, great time with this season. Leaving, it was sad, but it was, I think the whole thing was worth it. Minus the rough. Bye-bye. This lip sync, it's my last chance to share a little bit of my country hometown twist.
And so I hope that y'all enjoy and have a great time with me.
It was gonna be fun.
You decamp.
Yay!
Your turn. Ooh! And now in the music video, the bitch produced herself, Utica!
Expect that from Unica. Wow.
Utica.
Utica.
Utica, wow.
Or find a store near you.
Oh my god, that was amazing.
We know people across our community are putting off checkups, vital screenings,
catch
and
it.
Nagging symptoms. That's why we're here to remind everyone it can't wait. Advanced early detection and
so
ongoing care are critical. Don't put off your health another day.
Kind of catch his sense of humor.
Are you tired of clean clothes just smell clean?
Keeps getting away from him.
The queen with the $1 million smile.
Got
Lux, be a lady tonight. I'm Olivia Lux, and I like to light up a room whenever I walk into a space. I think I've coined the phrase polite diva because I'm still polite. I can still be a diva though.
They all claim to choose the biggest diva. I think.
Watching myself back on Drag Race was mind-blowing.
How long have you been drag?
Like a year and a half.
A year and a half.
You have to kind of have more confidence in yourself. So I feel like every asset of me as a drag queen was tested.
Don't say that out loud.
So my favorite was the disco.
But she won two. She won two, right?
The I think so. When yeah. I found that diva in Olivia that I was kind of looking for.
You have what they call it factor. I mean, it's just you are radiant.
May I ask a question? Question. I just remember everyone making fun of me when I needed help because I would be like, hi, is there anyone that you want to help me with my nails? And everyone's like, Olivia, I'm such a diva.
Okay.
The second win, right after the first win, they were kind of like, okay, wait. Time out, this girl. We need to kind of look out for her. And that felt good. Maybe I'll go to France and be a mime.
Oh my god.
This season, I felt so fierce, I felt so fun. A lot of my looks were nods to nostalgia,
and
then experience about the simpler times.
Oh, that was
true.
Some
pretty.
Good
love.
Pretty.
Yeah.
Ooh, shit got hard.
Everybody.
I was the majority vote.
Oh, yeah.
Twice.
Me,
majority vote twice. Yes.
I know.
Oh my god.
That everyone's answer kind of has nothing to do with me. We're all on our own different journeys. There's no real way to compare. Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor, so go out and get it and chase your dreams.
I love it.
I also learned how to lay down baby hair from Simone. That is actually probably the biggest advantage.
I can't believe she won with that hair.
See it? It's all just cut unevenly.
My show.
Now, it's about to go down.
Back
with Olivia.
Shella.
Clearly doesn't know how to play piano.
Maybe she may.
Well, maybe she was just pushing there. I could see that, yeah.
Does it looks good?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Her makeup is amazing. And the lighting?
Yeah.
Who thought this? Like, this is amazing. This is kind of an old kind of way to film something, yeah. That would have been, could have been 90s, yeah. But Mary J. Blige.
This bike,
yeah. Yeah. The whole thing looks like a 90s video, but it's done well. Her makeup is good. That.
Favorite.
That was your favorite?
Yeah.
My favorite is Joey J.
Is that Peter Olivia
Lux? Still.
Hi, Utica.
Hi there.
Utica, early on you cracked Rue up when she asked you about weed. Have you ever smoked weed before? What were you thinking about in that moment?
Well, I wanted to be honest, but then I had the thought, oh my god, I'm on national TV. So then I was like, answer, but don't answer. But then answer again, but then don't. And then she just started laughing at me. And I was like, oh my gosh, I just gotta keep up the pattern and see what happens.
You see what happens on TV?
I could out with you.
All right, Olivia, there are rumors that you and Utica have been on a date. Is that true? If not,
that's
are there plans for one?
I don't know. I have seen you after the show.
The food was delicious.
The food was really delicious. It was really good. Hello, baby.
Thank you.
Welcome back, queen.
Are they a couple?
Man, I don't think so.
They're just trying to tell us enough to not tell us anything.
For the first time ever, I'm choosing two lip sync assassins of the season. Lallery.
Jiwon.
And Denali.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, I thought you remember that poor
Bruce. That looked good.
And toe-to-toe
what?
In a Hershey-making lip-sync smackdown for charity. The winner will earn $10,000 for the charity of her choice.
Wow.
Wow.
Just to screw La La Rio over, they're going to do it on ice. Why not Elliot? Poor Elliot. Just thinking, I can dance.
I know.
What about me?
For our charity, we first, coming to us from Roscoe's in Chicago, it's Denali.
Hi, Rue.
Oh, wow.
Denali, tell us who you're lip-syncing for.
The charity I'll be lip-syncing for is the National Center for Transgender Equality. La La Girl, I love you, but this is my redemption.
Fantastic. And
yay.
Coming to us from my sister's room in Atlanta, it's Lala Ree. Lala, who are you lip-syncing for?
Hey, Rue, I am lip-syncing for the National Black Justice Coalition, dedicated to the empowerment of the Black LGBTQ plus community. Mama, sister, I love you, but you better watch out for all.
Both great charities. Now, two lip-sync assassins stand before me. Prior to tonight, you were asked to prepare a lip-sync performance of Be My Lover by LaBouche. Ladies, this is your last chance to press me and earn $10,000 for the cause of
I have no idea. Is it on a skin link?
Just bet. Just bet without even knowing. That's my point.
I don't know this song, though.
Okay. I think Lallery will win.
I have not a clue. Okay, then Denali.
Good.
Get up.
They're both dancers. But I think Denali can do routines, maybe.
I know this song. Yay.
Now I almost look like she's thinking about it.
Wow.
How did they did not know that they each were gonna do that? I guess that must be a new thing that everybody's gotta know how to do.
To me, Denali was working.
Yeah, but I think La La Ree won that.
Denali, you're a winner, baby.
Oh.
Yay!
Your charity will receive.
I was right.
I'm thinking about the charity.
Yeah. I was right.
And I'm so glad that my splits and flips are going to benefit my trans brothers and sisters.
Good. My splits and flips.
In the spirit of giving, your charity will receive a donation of $5,000.
Yay! Oh.
Thank you so much for that. I had so much fun performing with you, Miss Denali girl. You are thinking of the style. Congratulations, girl. Thanks, ladies. All charity, no shade. Now, my final question. Tell us, why should you be America's next drag superstar? Got Mick.
I basically grew up with the show now, and every person that was crowned always opened my mind. The world is not black or white. It is this craziest gray area, and that's what my drag is. And I've grown so much here. I'm so ready to be crowned and be the representation that I wish I had growing up. And that's why I'm America's Next Drag Superstar.
Yes. Team got me. Team got me.
Yes.
There is no rule book that says that America's Next Drag Superstar has to be perfect. I've fallen 100 times and gotten up 101 times because I have the fire in my belly. There is an entire community of Afro-Latino, brown, loud, and a gay voice back in the hood that are looking up to this big bitch right here on this main stage like, damn. And that's what I want to show the world. It is okay to be big. It is okay to be loud. I feel like a queen already. Crown it.
Go, Candy. Go.
Thank you. Okay.
I should be crowned America's Next Drag Superstar.
She looks like a robot right now.
Because as I've demonstrated, there is just about nothing I can't do. There is a drag queen who I admire and look up to. She's a great hostess. She has a TV show. She sings. Her name is Lady Bunny. Her name is RuPaul. When I think of myself in the future, I hope and see something like you. And as I've showed you all here every single week, I can do all of it really well. Thank you.
Thank you. Simone.
She's got a lot of Botox, but I couldn't see much emotion.
I believed all those negative things that people said about me. But I kept going forward and I said, there's something there out there in this world that I'm good at. And I found drag. Throughout these weeks, I fought and I've shown myself and I took down the walls that I built up to protect myself. And I feel like my drag is really inspirational. There are 1,000,001 Reggies out there who need somebody like me. I'm a beautiful person and I'm willing to fight for what is mine. And, that's why I'm America's Next Drag Superstar. Thank you.
Yay.
Team Simone! Go Simone!
For next week, Lip Sync Smackdown to the crowd. Who are you rooting for? Are you Team Got Mick?
Yay!
Team Candy?
Okay.
Team Rosé?
Oh!
team. Sound off and let us know. And remember, if you can't love yourself,
how the hell are you gonna love somebody else?
Can I get an amen up in here?
Amen.
Nah. All right, so what did you guys think about this episode?
Wasn't it crazy?
So who was your favorite music video for those anime queens? I love the Joy J. I love the the voice band vibe, and she played every role, and
that was funny.
That was funny. So I loved it.
True.
One that stood out was Utica's, because this is her not doing anything funny, goofy.
Right.
She was doing taking herself serious.
Right.
That was good. There were quite a few that were really good. Mm-hmm. They were all very well produced.
Olivia, Utica.
Olivia's was great.
And Joey J.
Joey J. That was probably one of the top.
Mm-hmm. I like Tanisha. It's very, very.
Her dance song was a good dance song. Mm-hmm.
All of them were.
Yeah.
Even like Kimora Hall.
Can't talk no shit about nobody.
Beautiful.
So we all liked them. That's all.
Yeah. That was great. So you still team Lose and team Simon still?
Are you still?
I am like 300% team Rose will be forever. I'll go buy all the merch, all the books, all the future.
Hopefully she's gonna come down to Dallas someday.
And yes. I'm still team Simone.
Yeah.
Team got me.
Either I'm one or the other, man. You can't always do that.
No, it's Simone, but if Gottmik got it, I think
rooting
that's...
for Gottmik too, but I'm not saying that.
Right,
so, I'm not going to be that.
I would. Either one or the other. That. No, I can't. There's a lot of gray, darling. I live in the gray, just like Gottmik.
Okay.
There's lots of gray. Ain't no black and white.
Please comment below and tell us what you thought. All right, have a wonderful week. Janet.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, B. Winter.